Hi everyone, today we're doing our third store audit for a super fun science shop. Before we get started, let me introduce myself in case you're new to my channel. My name is Blanca from TeacherTechFiles.com and I'm a learning strategist from Las Vegas. And on this channel, we talk about how to integrate technology in the classroom and also how to be successful on Teachers Pay Teachers. So if that sounds like something that you're interested in, make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any future videos. I hope you're enjoying your summer break if you're already on it. It's a much needed break for all of us. Here in Las Vegas, it's already been 110 degrees. Today it's a nice cool 98, so for us, that's a win. And if you haven't started your break yet, just keep pushing through. I'm sure it's coming soon. Just know that we'll all be jealous of you when we have to go back to school and you're still on vacation. So let's go ahead and get started with the review. Okay, first of all, if you haven't grabbed your free successful store setup checklist, pause this video and go get it right now. You can print it out or pull it up on your iPad if you're more techie like me and help audit this store right along with me. All right, so the name of the store that we'll be auditing today is ScienceSpad. The owner of the store is Trace and he reached out to me via email. Trace is a science teacher and he says that he started his TPT store in February of 2021, so he's only in his fourth full month of the platform. But from what he's told me, he's doing pretty well so far. He said that he made $32 in sales his first month, $252 in the second month, and $230 in March. So to go from $32 to a little over $250 in the span of 1 month is a pretty big jump, and I'm guessing that part of his success is the niche that he's in. I don't really like talking about niching down, but I do think it's important because if you are in a field where there's just a million resources, it'll be harder to get noticed. But for Trace, he's in the science field, which doesn't really have that many resources available. So I think he's got a really good start to his store. I know the science teacher in my school often says there aren't enough science resources that are Common Core aligned. So if he's providing that, then I think he has great market advantage. Trace also told me that his store is mainly a hobby right now, but that he would of course love it to be big enough to become his main source of income one day. And I think that's definitely most of our goals for our stores, especially after we see the passive income start to kind of roll in. It's kind of nice to just be sitting at home watching TV or watching a movie or doing really anything and hearing that cha-ching go off on your phone. Which by the way, if you don't have the app on your phone, I would definitely download it. It has kind of bare bone features, but hearing that cha-ching is pretty satisfying. And that's why I really like encouraging other teachers to get started on TPT, because it's easy to get started and can bring in some extra cash every month for resources that you're probably already making anyway. All right, so let's get started by taking a look at his store and sharing some observations. We're gonna start with the first category, which is overall look and design. Remember that this overall look and design is all about brand recognition. You want people to know which products are yours so that they buy from you since they know that your brand produces quality products. The first thing I'm looking for in this category are custom logos and banners. Right off the bat, I'm obsessed with his logo. This little frog is just too dang cute, and the front is really easy to read. I really love that the little fly is acting as the dot on the eye too. It's a super cute touch. I think the banner up here is also easy to read, and the only thing I would suggest is to extend the time between each switch just a little bit so that it's a little bit easier to read what's on each banner. But both banners are definitely serving their purpose, which is to get your attention on the featured products and to tell buyers what type of resources you sell. Okay, next we're looking to see if he has a definable brand and cohesive product covers. These two go hand in hand because if your product covers are cohesive, then your brand is more likely to be definable. Scrolling down under bestsellers, I can see that overall, he tends to use the same 3 or 4 fonts, but not necessarily the same colors or in the same format. I would recommend narrowing down the fonts that you use to 1 or 2 instead. It will really help the cover images become more recognizably yours. But let's just use these two products here as an example, the Build-A-Cell and the Hobbit. He used different fonts for both of these product covers. One has his logo on it and the other one doesn't, and the information that he provided is different on each two. Like this one has the grade levels that it's for, but nothing else, and this one has info on what's included, but not for what grade level. So there's just enough discrepancy here for me to not be able to recognize that these two products were made by the same person, which is not great if you're trying to build brand recognition. If I go to the second page and look at these three products here, I see that they're starting to look more similar, which is good. The Plant Cell Lesson has the black bars at the top and the bottom, and these other two only have the bar at the bottom. And although this may seem like a really small detail, I can see that the black bars are different shapes, with one having the round edges and the other one having straight edges. And it catches my eye just enough to be worth mentioning. I personally like the black bar because it makes the text at the bottom stand out more. If this mutation ones at the bottom had the black bar, I'd be able to read the words in pink easier, which is always the goal, because remember that a lot of people browse TPT on their phones, so the covers show up really small, which means that we have to do our best to make them super legible. As you guys can probably tell, I am really big on having your product covers be as consistent as possible. I'm not saying they need to be exactly the same, but they should follow a similar format. Not only will this help with your brand recognition, but it will make your life as a TPT seller a lot easier because you'll have a template to work from, which will speed up your process in creating these preview thumbnails by a lot. What do you guys think so far? Do you agree with my observations and suggestions? Let me know in the comments below. All right, next we're moving to the second category, which is the store's organization. We want to check for custom categories, amount of products, and that the freebie that he's offering is high quality. It looks like Trace has plenty of custom categories, so if I were a buyer, I could easily see what he has to offer and see if he has what I'm looking for. I do see some English lessons which are not science related, which initially looks a little bit strange since his store is for science resources. But that could have just been something he had already made for his class and that he decided to upload, and overall, I don't think it's a huge deal. Total, it looks like he has 80 products, which is awesome considering he's only been open for a few months. So far, everything in this store is looking really good to me. It has a really good start. But there is one thing that kind of threw me off, and that's the freebie. And my thoughts here might be a little controversial, so I'd love to know what everyone else thinks. I think the purpose of the TPT freebie is to give your buyers an instant insight into the quality of work that they can expect from you. When they click on it, they're expecting to receive an instant freebie. However, when I click on his freebie, he's asking me to sign up for his mailing list first, and then I'll receive the free product. What do you guys think about this? Is it a genius way to get more people onto your mailing list? Or is it going to leave a bad taste in buyers' mouth and not want to purchase anything else from your store? Personally, I don't think this is a very good tactic because it feels a little bit like a bait and switch. You're telling the buyer that they're going to be receiving this free sell worksheet, but when they click on the link, they don't get what they're expecting. So right off the bat, a buyer might be a little bit nervous about spending money to purchase a product because they might think that they won't actually receive what is being advertised, kind of like what happened in this freebie. Always think of your freebie as a way to give people a really great first impression of your store. So make sure that the quality of the freebie is going to be great and that it's really easy for the buyer to receive it. Remember that if you've hooked them with your freebie, they are much more likely to spend money on other products from your store. All right, the next category on my TPT Setup for Success checklist are the product descriptions. I made a whole video on how to write product descriptions that convert to sales. So if you're curious about how to write them and what should be included, check out that video after this. I'll link it down below. I'm gonna pick a random resource here to look at the product description. Let's look at one of his best sellers called Science Camp Activities. Right away, I can see that it's pretty easy to read. He's making good use of the bold print to separate his sections, and he's also using bullet points, which I really like. The snippet at the top is full of keywords, so I would think that this is probably going to help your product rank higher. I don't see any way of contacting you, so I would probably add that at the bottom here. I think it also helps with giving the buyers peace of mind that if they have any questions or need any help, they have an easy way of contacting you. The last thing I want to mention here is that the grade level range here is huge. He has it listed as a product that is suitable for pre-K all the way to 9th grade. And to me, that is just way too big of a learning difference and even physical abilities. I think this will throw off buyers because pre-K teachers know that they won't be able to do activities that are also intended for 9th graders, and 9th grade teachers won't want to buy something that may be so easy that even a 3-year-old would be able to do. When we look at just the topics being covered, a pre-K student would never really be learning about cells. So I know that this won't be a suitable lesson for them. So in short, I would recommend either narrowing down this grade level range or breaking it up so that you have a bundle for elementary and a bundle for middle and high school students. The very last thing we're gonna be looking at are the product previews. On this Science Cap bundle, I can see that he did use all 4 thumbnails, which is always step one. You always, always wanna use all 4 thumbnails. He also included a video preview, which is really helpful. I think the only way to level up your product preview is to show the actual product in action versus the screenshots. I think that showing those crafts and booklets with the stamps would get teachers more excited to buy it, since they're able to see what the final product would look like for their students. Teachers always wonder if their class is going to like the products that we're buying for them, so you can remove that doubt if you show them your class being super excited about this, and I think that that would help them not hesitate to purchase it. Alright guys, we made it to the end of our newest store audit. This was super fun for me to record, and I hope that you enjoyed it too. If you were following along with your own checklist, please make sure to comment below and let me know if you agreed with my observations or if you caught something that maybe I missed. I want to say thank you so much to Trace for allowing me to nitpick at his store, but I really hope that you found that helpful. If you'd like your store to be featured in a future store audit, please go to my website and fill out the form. I'm really looking forward to the next one, and I hope that you are too, because making this type of video is so much fun. Anyway, I hope you're enjoying the summer, and as always, keep the comments kind, and I'll see you in my other videos.